cultures, what happens in our life is totally up to the individual. And that's why I stay the way I am. Because of the name I carried, the Piutluck, who was a war chief that fought under Chief Joseph. Mm. So he carried a war whistle, I carry a prayer whistle.
Their information for us to see the world differently or to understand how to be in this waterway.
It goes back to the storytelling. When you talk about stories, that's where you're actually, a lot of our information, if we have some, is from our elders, and we have to actually auto-report them.
Butterballs, teal, shags, black ducks, mallards, pigeons, golden eyes, butterballs, teal. China used to be the second most populated in BC for octopus, which used to be a stable part of our diet. We're lucky just to catch those little ones now. We're used to catch the ones with the big long arms on them. Everything is just overfished, over-controlled by the government. And we're still stopped at gunpoint when we're out hunting, fishing, clamming. We're still stopped at gunpoint. That's what we asked them one time. Now that you got all our meat from our freezer, what are you going to do with it? He said, oh, we're going to bring it to the food shelters in town. I said, what? I said, you're stealing from people in poverty to feed the poverty you created in the city.
Uh-huh. Nation is right in the banger. So right here is Sartwick's Nation. This is Appleton. Deco where we just were by Green Rock. This is Sykum. And then Sayout would be right here.
Saanich, this is all one people. And then when we got our Douglas Treaty in 1852, like around that time frame, that's when we start getting allocated and cut into our own nation. So Sykum became their own nation, Pakwuchin, then there's Sartlet here, Malahat on this side. They used to be part of the five nations because it used to be just back and forth, seasonal. And then Sayout's on this side. So between all five nations, we used to make up the body of the Saanich before. So that's why the main language is.
Our clams up about a foot down where everything started to harden up. But it's becoming more solid. So if we didn't dig those beaches year after year, those beaches probably would have been dead.
So I'm thinking of you aerating your beach sands, you are priming the memories to come back.
Yeah.
And keep everything going forward.
Thank you.
Thank you.